Welcome to the Commerce Achiever platform. Through this platform, we are going to cover commerce and management related subjects, and we will give you a detailed learning of all the subjects with time to time and serve you with different courses so that you get a quality knowledge. So to get the expertise knowledge, kindly subscribe our channel and click the bell icon so that you get the notification of the latest videos. Through this video, we are going to understand the continued portion of the previous videos, that the undisclosed source of income, the how to identify the previous year. Okay, so in this we will deal in English. Few students want in Hindi, so we are covering in Hindi the separate videos, so that the students want to go in Hindi, they can choose the Hindi, and this is for the English students, those who want the understanding in English. So let's see the undisclosed, so previous year, in case of undisclosed source of income. Okay, so generally what is in the previous year is year in which income is earned, okay, and it is taxable in the assessment year. In case of any doubt, please, it's covered in a separate video, go and see that videos, because the basic understanding of the previous year and assessment year is most important in the case of income tax. Okay, it's a base of income tax actually. Okay, so what we'll do in case of previous year, in case of an undisclosed source of income, what will be the previous year? Okay, generally the previous year the income earned and it's taxable in the assessment year, but there are few exceptions, okay, where income is not disclosed, it's a not disclosed by the assessee, okay, or it is not disclosed by the assessee and it is detected by the income tax officer, who known as an assessing officer, that is now we will pronounce as AO, okay. So it's not disclosed by an assessee and it is detected by the income tax officer, okay, and that is an assessing officer, and the assessee gives explanation. AO asks for the explanation. Assessee gives either no explanations or give an unsatisfactory explanation in the opinion of the AO. So then what will be the previous year in that case? In that case, as per the Income Tax Act, the previous year the income will be deemed to be the income of the assessee. The income which is undisclosed income will be deemed income, will be treated as an deemed income of assessee in the year in which it is so detected. Look, I'm trying to write also because few students have a hearing problem, so that's why I'm writing a bit everything. I'm trying to help those students also. So in case of any doubt, any assistance, please feel free to ask, okay, because few students have a hearing issue, so they requested to write, so that's why I'm trying to write a shortcuts for them, okay. So the income deemed as the income, okay, for the assessee, okay, for the assessee in the year in which the income so detected by the income tax officer or the assessing officer, okay. So what are those cases, what are those undisclosed okay incomes? Let's see. First, it is a cash credit which is covered under section 68. Second, it is unexplained investments, which is covered under section 69. And then we have third one is unexplained money or other valuable items, we can say it's used in an etc. It's section 69A, okay. And then we have amount of investment or etc. may we can say money, jewelry, other valuable item not fully disclosed, okay, in books of accounts of the assessee. It is covered under section 69B, okay. And then fifth, we have unexplained expenditure, okay, unexplained expenditure covered in section 69C. And in last case will be the sixth case, amount borrowed or repaid for what? Hundi. Okay? Most students don't know the meaning. Kindly refer on and I'll share the link. Or if most of the students don't know, please mention in the comment section. I'll give you a separate video for explaining the meaning of hundi. Okay? It's covered in section 69D. Okay? So let's see the detail of each. First, we will deal with the cash credit, which is covered under section 68. Sorry, section 68. Okay, an amount is credited. Okay, an amount is credited in the books of an account of the assessee. Okay, amount is credited in the books of your account of the assessee. And assessee ask for the explanation. Okay, who can ask for the explanation? AO. AO asks for the explanations with the assessee. And assessee gives an, either it gives no explanation, okay, or given unsatisfactory explanations in opinion of AO. Okay? So in the opinion of the AO, it doesn't give the good explanations. Okay? Then what AO will say, if it's either not give the explanation or given unsatisfactory explanation in the opinion of the AO, then AO says whatever amount is credited will be deemed as income of assessee of that previous year. That means the year in which income is detected. Okay, I hope it's clear. Come on, switch to the next point. Second, we will deal unexplained investments. Unexplained investment, which is covered under section 69. Okay. Suppose an assessee make an investment in immediately preceding year. Okay, preceding like in a previous year. That is immediately preceding. Immediately, it will be difficult for the students. Immediately preceding assessment year, like say in a previous year, and assessee has made an investment. Assessee what made? He made an investment. Okay, and not recorded in his books of accounts. It isn't recorded in his books of account. And okay, assessee AO asked for the explanation from the assessee. Okay, and what did assessee do? Assessee offers either no explanations or given unsatisfactory explanations in the opinion of the AO of source and nature of investments. Source and nature of investment. Okay? He offers either no explanations or given unsatisfactory explanations that how assessee has made this investment, from where he get the amount, okay, and how he did that investment. Assessee doesn't give the explanation or give an unsatisfactory explanation about the source and nature of the investment. Then what AO will do? Okay, then AO will make that the amount you have invested, okay, the amount put, the value of money of investment will be treated as deemed income of the assessee of such financial year. Okay, I hope it's clear. Take a quick recap. Unexplained investment. Assessee made an investment. Okay, assessee doesn't record it in the books of account. Okay, AO find it the investment. AO asks for the explanations from the assessee. Assessee either doesn't give in the explanation, that is, as in assessee gives no explanation or given unsatisfactory explanation in the opinion of the AO about what? About the source of investment or nature of investment. Source and nature, both source and nature of investment. Then what AO do? AO treated the value of investment as a deemed income. Value of investment as a deemed income of such financial year. Okay, next, switch to the third, that is an unexplained money, etc. It's covered in the section 69A. Okay, in any financial year, suppose in any financial year, assessee have money with, found its owner. Owner of what? Owner of money, bullion, jewelry or other valuable article. Okay, and any of these is found as an owner, is found as an owner, and he doesn't record it in the books of account, not recorded, okay, not recorded in his books of account. Okay, and when it is asked for the explanation about what, explanation of the nature of these items or and source of these items, okay, either he offers no explanations or unsatisfactory explanations in the opinion of the AO, okay, then the value of these item or the money of which he is found as an owner will be deemed as income of assessee of such financial year. Okay, I hope this is clear, same as in above. Okay, few items are different only. Okay, let's switch to the next fourth point. Amount of investment, etc. Not fully disclosed in books of accounts covered under section 69B. Okay, suppose in any financial year, assessee is found as an owner of, assessee has shown as an investment, or found as an owner of what, jewelry, bullion, or any money he kept with it, or other any valuable article. Okay, he holds an investment or found as an owner. Okay, he showed in his books of account. This time he showed in his books of account, but that is a less value. And according to the AO, the value is more. Okay, value is more. Then AO asks an explanation. AO asks for the explanation with the assessee, and assessee either give no explanations or given unsatisfactory explanations in the opinion of AO. Okay, then the excess amount, only the excess figure, not the full figure, only the excess figure will be deemed as an income of the assessee in the such financial year. Okay, I hope it is clear. Okay, now switch to the fifth point, unexplained expenditure, section 69C. Okay, suppose an assessee incur an expenditure, any kind of an expenditure, and AO asks for the explanation. Okay, AO asks for the explanations about what, about the source of such expenditure. Okay, about the source of such expenditure, and assessee either give no explanations or give unsatisfactory explanations in the opinion of the AO. Okay, then what AO will do? AO will do two steps. First, it deemed as income of the assessee, treated as an deemed income. That unexplained expenditure will be treated as an income of the assessee in such financial year. And next, that expenditure is not allowed as deduction. Okay, that is not allowed as deduction under any head of income. Okay, any head of income. Okay, please student, do not confuse with the deduction word. Here the deduction means, suppose you are doing any kind of business, you prepare a P&L, you have an income. Suppose you made a sale and you have an income, and you are doing expenses like in stationery, electricity bill, okay, water bill, society bill, other different kind of expenses you are incurring. Okay, so this expenditure, suppose this is an X expenditure, AO asks for the explanation. You offer no explanation or unsatisfactory explanations, then this amount will be treated as an income first, and second, this expenditure will not be allowed as deduction. If it is not allowed as a deduction, your income will be increased. Okay, your income will be increased and you are liable to tax. So it will not allow as deduction, and it is treated as a deemed income of an SSA. Okay, next, the last point, the sixth point, the amount borrowed or repaid on hundi. Okay, which is covered under section 69D. Okay, where any kind of amount borrowed or any amount is repaid on hundi. Okay, but that is other than account paycheck, other than account pay check drawn on bank, ठीक है, other than this source, ठीक है, then it will be treated as an income of the person, ठीक है, either borrowing or the repaying, ठीक है, it is the income of the person in the previous year in which amount is so borrowed or it is repaid as case may be. Suppose an assessee borrowed or repaid by way of account pay check, then it will not be treated as an income, okay, it will allowed, okay, and if it's other than account pay check, it will be treated as a deemed income of an assessee in the year in which it is borrowed or the repaid as case may be, okay, it will be deemed as an income, okay, and suppose it is be deemed as an income of any person, then it will not again liable to be assessed in respect of such amount or repayment. Means suppose during borrowing, when one has borrowed, okay, other than this source and treated as an income, and after few years it's starting repayment, then once it is treated as income, it doesn't treat it as income again, only one time one tax, okay, not again and again, okay. So I hope you are clear with all the 6 points. In case of any doubt, feel free to ask in the comment sections, and you can join us on our Telegram channel or our group, Facebook group also. We have a Facebook channel also. There are various social platform. Your query must be resolved, and student asking for the hard copy, it will, for that you have to contact us, kindly contact us and visit our website www.commerceachiever.com. So keep learning, getting a quality knowledge. Please subscribe our channel and click the bell icon so that you get all the quality content as and when it is uploaded. And I'll request you, if you like our videos, please thumbs up. And if you don't like, please give us in the comment section your suggestions. We will take care of your suggestions if possible. And please share and motivate us by sharing the videos to the maximum students. So stay connected with us. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.